Sound good? All right, cool. Pretty good turnout tonight, even though Erica Badu's live. Big surprise. Is this your intro music, Brett?
You there? Can anybody hear me? Hold on a second.
Can hear you.
Trying to adjust this. All right, what's up?
Hey, sexy people! What's up, fans?
All right, you all set?
Hear me?
You all set?
Everyone can hear both of us?
Where you at, man?
I wonder why that is. It's a mystery.
Do a show, or are we going to do radio?
Okay, so, Brett.
What's up?
I thought you were going to be on camera, Brett. That doesn't look like you. That's, I mean, I know that's what you want to look like, but...
You first.
All right, Brett, so it's cool with you if I direct this conversation for a while? And then you can say whatever you want when I'm all done?
You yourself on video? You got to show yourself on video?
Nope. Nope.
Why not?
You knew I wasn't going to, and you showed up, so...
Why wouldn't you want to?
I'll answer your questions after you answer mine. How about that?
How about we do it where we show our face?
Are you refusing to answer my questions if I don't show my face? Is that what's happening now?
Come on, show your face.
These people dig the shit out of you, man. Come on.
Oh, your little buddy's in here. Wow.
Hold on a second.
Why am I not surprised that your dribbling retard of a lackey is with you? I thought this was going to be one-on-one.
We were sitting here on Skype waiting to sit here and do this. I just hung up with him. So what's up? Are you going to show yourself, or are we going to sit behind our screens and hide all night and do that kind of silly stuff? Come on, man. I'm letting you have everything
option
you want.
Two,
all you
got to
do is
right.
Just show yourself, dope. What's option
right,
number two?
Right. Let me have everything I want, and you'll answer my questions, and then you can ask whatever you want to ask.
All right, go ahead.
Okay. So we're here to talk about these false allegations that I've made against you, right?
Go ahead and ask me whatever you like.
What you call false allegations.
Yeah.
Alright, so I guess we'll start off with basically what's happened between you and me. My first question.
Are you having a delay or something?
My recent video, the debate challenge.
Alright.
Sorry.
You did a debate challenge. You did a debate challenge.
Do you have headphones or something, Brett?
No. Are you lagging? Do you want to connect through Skype? Is this a problem?
I can hear an echo.
Jeez, I ain't got no headphones, man. You want to go through Skype on this maybe to be better? I didn't realize there'd be this much lag. Well, actually, I did. I said this to you.
Yeah.
Let's do Skype and you can broadcast me.
The lag isn't that bad, but I can hear myself through your mic.
You want to try doing Skype then?
Sure,
no, I can't afford headphones, folks. What a surprise. Alright, let's do that.
Right,
I got
why
Skype
didn't you put it on your wish list.
Yeah, right. Come on, man. Just open up your Skype, add me, and we'll broadcast that way. Come on, let's not ruin the show here.
Skype's
we won't
open,
have, to...
have you added.
Alright, let's see what we got here. All right. Can you close me out of the broadcast over there so we don't echo? Go ahead and shut my broadcast down here, or maybe I can do that, and you can broadcast me through your computer, right? Are you able to?
Yeah, let's just make sure everyone can hear you. This is worse. I can't believe you don't have headphones.
Well, dude, I told you I'm poor as fuck. What do you want from me? All right. Let me try turning my shit down over here and see if that helps. How's that? Is that better?
Can everybody hear Brett? Brett, say something. Nah, that's terrible.
I told you Black TV sucks, man. Yeah. Haven't you done a show on this thing before with co-hosting?
I haven't actually. Hey, Brett, I thought you said that your wife had an MP3 player that crapped out. She didn't have headphones?
Let me
mute
this real quick on the Vlog TV. There we go. How's that? Try now.
Okay.
See if you still echo. How's that?
I can hear you. Am I echoing?
No, you... Okay.
Everybody hears Brett?
All right. No.
All right, cool. All right, so Brett, first thing I want to ask you is, did you file a privacy complaint on my debate challenge video?
Absolutely not.
The thing is, I just find that a little hard to believe, since you have filed false privacy complaints before, or at least you've made false privacy complaints before, haven't you?
You have any evidence for that?
Yes, actually I do.
Here, okay, go ahead and show it.
How about I provide a link?
Let me see.
Just give me one second. For some reason, my text isn't working in Blog TV. Oh, there we go. All right, cool.
All right, let's see what we got here.
All right.
Let's see.
So I'm just going to read that quickly, okay? You say, people have somehow got my personal info on YouTube. Now there is several videos mirrored with my real name slandering me. You show your real name. You say your real name in every video you make. So how is that not a false privacy complaint?
Let me see this.
Yeah, take a look.
What is this that I'm looking at?
Did you get the link?
Yeah, I'm sitting here looking at this. What is this?
This is you on the YouTube help forums complaining about people using your real name in videos to quote-unquote slander you. What is it?
Let me see this.
Can you read?
Yeah, I'm getting my glasses on. Hold on.
Oh, okay. Are you sure you're not taking some time to think about it?
I'm trying to read this.
Okay. Let me know.
Yeah, it says right here, basically, this must have been done a while back and everything, but this isn't like some kind of privacy complaint. This is some like blog deal on YouTube. Some people were dropping my docs and video responses. Somebody posted a video to me basically having my personal information in it.
Yeah, your real name. You say right there, your real name.
Mm.
Which is what
And it had my docs in it, but I wasn't going to sit there and put my docs on that situation.
Oh, you didn't mention that it was any other information. I mean, that's pretty serious if people are putting out your phone number or your address. You're not going to put that in your complaint.
Well, I've said this in video several times, dope and shit. I'm sure you've probably heard it. I got people who drop my docs. I got people who sit there and flag me. I've also on Facebook. I've posted pink slips and everything like that. People seen it. Recently, I got a somebody flagged me for a Coughlin video and stuff having to do with Austin Powers.
That's totally irrelevant. I'm not talking about any of your flagging. I'm talking about you complaining that people are using your real name, which is obviously what you're doing there. People were posting your address. You would mention that because that would be an urgent situation. So you're basically, you want to be selective here and say these people used my real name and excuse a whole bunch of others. You're trying to manipulate the system. That's what you're doing.
It's obvious that if you look on your list and then your own blog TV and stuff, people are pretending to be me on the thing. They are sitting there saying crap.
Oh, so this wasn't you. This wasn't you who left this. Is that what you're saying now?
When someone sits there and drops your dots and stuff and tries to sit there and slander you, there's nothing wrong with leaving on a blog, but this isn't like, you know, some kind of what you're trying to put forth. This is just sitting there saying, look, I'm having a problem over here, and that's it.
It's a bullshit privacy complaint.
Did you see what this comment down here? It says they did it for the laws.
What's that? The comment is irrelevant. Someone came and commented. That has nothing to do with your complaint.
Well, you're asking me if something basically happened to your stuff because of me. Nobody ever replied to me. No one ever responded. This is basically about people dropping my docs.
Well, your real name, which you're saying is violating your privacy when you say your real name in every video. And all I'm saying is that's why I don't...
But I've already said twice that this is information people put out me. I just told you I get videos where people do that.
That's not what people do. Okay, if that's your story. I mean, I'm just saying why I don't believe you when you say you didn't file the privacy complaint against my video, because I see you bullshitting on the YouTube help forums. Anyway, we can move on.
If I think I'm in danger or something, if I think somebody's trying to hurt me and stuff, I will sit there and, you know, write out whatever I can. But you clearly see that YouTube doesn't give a shit about anything. They don't care when I get flagged.
Yeah, well, if you thought you were in danger and someone was putting out your real address, you would say, they're putting out my address, they're putting out my phone number. You said, they're using my real name to slander me. That's what you said in the complaint. I'm just not buying it, that's all.
No, whatever. I didn't expect to sit there and understand anyway. What do you care?
Of course, because you're bullshitting me. All right, let's move on, okay?
Yeah, whatever, dope.
Okay, did you...
From a guy who doesn't even show his face. Now, you asked me a question. Why won't you show your face? It's my turn.
No, it's not your turn. I'm gonna ask you...
You think I'm going to sit here and just...
I'm going to ask you...
And you're not going to let me ask you anything? That's not really reasonable.
It looks like you feel like you're in trouble here because now you want to try to...
No, I don't feel like I'm in trouble. I don't understand why you just can't show your face.
You're raising your voice, Brett. Are you okay?
No, I am not okay. I'm sitting here having a faceless troll, basically... question me, and you don't want to answer my questions. Well, I think that's ridiculous. I thought this was a debate.
You thought that you could come here and prove that what this quote-unquote faceless troll said is bullshit, and you thought you could smack it down easily. That's why you're here. You knew I wasn't going to show my face, so you could get off that point, or you could waste a whole bunch of time and show that obviously you have nothing to say against what I've said about you and what everyone else has said about you.
You have no validity. I'm sorry. You're just a guy who's running your mouth.
Oh, okay. That's an ad hominem.
Well, you can say that if you want, but that's all you've been doing in your videos towards me. You talk trash, you make fun of people's weight, you make fun of people's appearance, you sit there and you say all these allegations and all that.
Yes, Brett, I did call you a fat fuck once, and I know it's been keeping you up at nights for 2 fucking years.
Yeah, so why don't you show your appearance? For everybody.
Because I would like to keep my offline life separate from my
online life. It's okay for you to take people's face and make fun of the way people look.
You may not understand that other people have professional and personal lives that they may not want to be affected by their involvement on the internet. I mean, people sometimes lose their jobs because of their Facebook pages. People sometimes don't get jobs because of what's on the internet. And so I'm being wise. And I'm keeping it separate.
I understand.
There's your answer.
You're worried about people doing the same thing to you that you do to everybody else. I understand. Go ahead, ask your questions. Thanks.
Okay. Did you DMCA me a couple years ago? Did you have someone do it on your behalf?
No.
Have you ever had someone DMCA people on your behalf?
even though your videos are annoying to me, whenever people make all these videos, they advertise my channel. I'm not going to sit there and give people any kind of issue over that. I might leave some comments. I might even say some rough stuff to people who are talking trash. But you guys are basically advertising by what you do.
I don't really know what you're babbling about. I asked, have you ever had somebody DMCA people on your behalf in your name?
No.
You didn't have Firefly do this for you?
There was a parody that me and Firefly did a while back.
Oh, it was a parody.
Some crap up there. A parody.
Should I play the clip and people can decide if it's a parody?
You can play the clip, but it was a parody.
All right.
Anybody who knew Firefly knew that we were being silly back then.
I'm going to play the clip and people can make up their own minds if this seems like a parody. How about that?
All right, go ahead. Hello, folks. My name is Brett Keane, and there's going to be some changes in town going on. Mm-hmm. I am giving Firefly 515 co-ownership over the videos that are hosted on YouTube, as well as the ones that have been deleted in the past. Every single one of them, all 900 videos, he is co-owner to of my copyrighted videos. This means that he is able to make reports, he is able to basically have the authority to, if by law or by DMCAs, is what you point out, right, Firefly?
Yes.
He will be able to do these things. If you copy any of my videos, any of you trolls out there, haters, Firefly, as well as a few others, have the ability and the authority to be able to report you, basically in my name, getting rid of you and dealing with these illegal acts that are done on YouTube. This shouldn't even be happening in the first place. People shouldn't have to go through all this nonsense. But because there's so much going on and so many assholes who think that they're safe on the internet, they think they can get away with it. So right now I'm going to state this one more time. Firefly 515 has co-ownership of my videos. Any that I've ever hosted in the past that have been deleted or still exist today, he has the ownership of this on YouTube and can do this. Anything you want to say, Firefly?
Yes. Yes, I am now co-owner of every single video that you've ever posted on live video or on YouTube, and I own the copyright to every single video. If I see anybody messing with Brett King and illegally uploading his videos, then I will file DMCAs on your app and get you suspended and banned.
So are you sticking with the story that this was a parody?
Yeah, you can easily tell from that. I mean, the guy, we're basically going back and forth and saying that there's property of videos being handed over and all that. I don't even know if that's even possible to do something like that.
Do you think there's some kind of way
where you can just kind of give over the copyright of your videos? Do you even copyright your videos at all? I don't.
Brett, any video you make is automatically your copyright. You know this, obviously.
When you upload videos and stuff, it basically becomes free public domain and stuff, and people have, what is that thing called, where they basically can criticize, do stuff like that on some of these videos. So it's absolutely open to whoever wants to get a hold of it.
So what were you parodying? What were you parodying in this video? What were you making fun of?
Well, it's kind of like the Coughlin situation. Coughlin sat there and made some accusations and everything. Instead of making a video and wasting my time just going, no, Coughlin, that's not the case. You know, me and a buddy of mine, we sat there and we just made a video and we were being silly about it and stuff. Firefly, if you've ever watched any of his videos, there was one thing that we did too that was a parody. Where basically, I was dressing up like in a Halloween Grim Reaper outfit and stuff, and everybody was sitting there getting into that, and then everybody wanted to know if it was actually me, and then Firefly pulled the shroud back. It was a joke, and people thought it was funny. Of course, some people are like, oh, what? I thought it was Brett, you know, blah, blah, blah. It's just funny stuff on YouTube.
I don't see why another joke you did has anything to do with this. I mean, it was clear that this was not a parody, if for no other reason because 24 hours later people started getting DMCA'd. So are you saying that a whole bunch of other people started DMCA'ing hater videos after you made a parody? I mean, that's bullshit.
Do you
bullshit.
Have any evidence of, like, this 24-hour thing that you're talking about, of all this stuff going on that you're saying? Because it was a joke.
I was there. Well, a lot of people were there. Present
whatever you got. You're saying that within 24 hours of a parody video, stuff like this started happening all over YouTube? That sounds like a conspiracy to me.
Okay, Brett. If you want to claim that it was a parody, I'll move on to something else. You're saying this was a parody. And you've never had someone file a DMCA
in your name. It was just stupid crap and stuff. Me and Firefly, we were just basically milking. It's kind of like the Ozzy Osbourne thing where they accused him of biting the head off a dove a long time ago. He just milked it. Just something silly.
Man, you're so full of non sequiturs. It's unbelievable. All right.
Well, say
so,
what you want, man. Go ahead.
Okay, man. So then you left these comments on Crazy Crazy Caleb's video. I'm sure you know what I'm about to show people here.
All right, what you got?
So these are comments in which you address me as Edward and Ed, which is the name of a friend of mine who's an attorney, whose information we put into counter notices after he became a silent partner in my channel. And we use his information to counter DMCAs filed in your name against my channel. We use his information because I know that you're completely unscrupulous and you can't be trusted. And it didn't take you very long, and you put out some comments trying to intimidate me with legal action and trying to use my real name. So, basically, my first... Well, my first question is, how do you justify trying to expose my first name?
What do you mean, justify exposing your first name?
I mean, how do you justify the intent to write a comment addressing me by my first name? How do you justify it? Why do you think that's okay?
Well, because your best friend was always referring to you as that. Don't you keep an eye on Give Me a Break, Man?
Oh, shit.
That's how I know your name. Here.
Okay, play it, please.
There's the link right there. There's your buddy's video on his own channel.
So
that's how I knew your first name, because he said it. I don't know anything else about you. All I know is you're a YouTuber
who makes
comments and all that, and he mentioned your name in his video.
All right, Brett, hold on a second. I'm gonna play what I think the video is that you're referring to. Is that cool?
Sure.
Okay.
You gonna play it over the screen, or what you gonna do?
I have it in MP4. Manycam won't play it. However, you know, I hoped you were gonna pull this out, because people don't know this, but a few days ago you sent me a PM saying you should never have trusted Give Me a Break, Man, right? And unfortunately, you blew your load too early, because later that day you uploaded this video with Give Me a Break, Man saying the name Edward.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So what I have...
What's wrong with showing you that he's the one that basically said that?
Because right here is the video that you edited that from. Here, I'll play it.
But I will add a link in the description of this video that I got. Actually, I heard about this page a while ago and I'd forgotten about it, but I was talking to the Japundit guy, Edward, over at japundit.com. By the way, he does the podcast Japan Talk.
Okay, so...
I think it's .org, .com. I'll put the links in the description.
So what?
Well, there's a few problems. The first thing is that... let me show you what the Japundit guy looks like. This is the Japundit guy. He talks about Japan. You know I'm from Canada.
I don't know where you're from.
You write...
crap on your YouTube.
You wrote in that comment that you know I'm from Canada, and you know the laws in Canada, and all this crap, okay? So you were saying you know I'm in Canada. This is a 60-year-old man who talks about Japan, and this video was put out in September 2010, and you left these comments in December 2009. So do you want to change your story now, or
I watched Give Me a Break Man's videos and stuff before all the nonsense came down.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Different, if you check the description on the videos, he sits there and says, check out these different links and all that.
Oh, really?
When I heard that and I checked out the links and everything, I assumed that that's probably who he was talking about. I never seen this person's face or anything.
Okay, wait, where? Okay, give me a link where he refers to my username as Edward.
He, if you look in the links in his description, he says, check out these people. He's like doing, I think it's like a shout out video where he's basically saying, check out these different users.
And am I there? So, am I there?
Actually, what's funny about that now is if you sit there and you click on any of those links, most of them, they show up, but that particular one, it doesn't anymore. You can click on the link, it's still there, but okay, the page that it was supposed to be directed to
Brett,
is no longer available.
The video was posted almost a year after you left these comments. And you edited out, well, actually, your retard of a lackey edited out the Japundit guy from the video in his, it was a terrible editing job for one thing. You can hear it buzzing in between. So, why are you even trying to play this off? It's so obvious what's going on.
Well, I have no idea what you're talking about. Your buddy right there in the video sat there and said Edward, and that's the end of the story. That's how I knew your name. That's it.
Brett,
why is that a big deal? You know my
Brett,
name. I thought everybody knows
Brett
Keane is me.
Give me a break, man. Mentions like 10 names per video. So you're saying that almost a year later you heard the name Edward. This isn't adding up at all. You're struggling, seriously.
I'm not struggling whatsoever. So that's it.
So that's how.
Not Edward, whoop-de-doo, move along. My name's Brett Keane. Nice to meet you. Let's move along.
Brett, do you want me to continue to debunk your claim? I mean, I think it's been debunked pretty thoroughly, but I can go on. I have more video evidence of you giving different explanations, not mentioning Give Me a Break Man at all. So is that what you would like me to do? I don't think it's necessary, to be honest, because you pretty much look like a huge liar right now.
You say that. You say whatever and stuff. That doesn't matter to me. I'm telling you basically where it is. I gave you a link, and that's it. I don't see what the big deal is anyway. What do you care?
Give me the link again.
Huh?
Give me the link again, please.
All right. Jeez.
You know, one thing that really bothers
me. Hold on a second. Got too many pages open here.
Yeah.
Shit, where the hell is it?
That was the original video.
Yeah.
Was it not?
That's what I'm trying to hook you up with. Okay.
Brett, I want the link. Just give me the link.
Okay, I'm putting it in Skype.
Putting it in Skype.
Can you see it?
Just put it in Blog TV so everyone can see it, please.
All right, hold on a second. Oh, boy.
I'm sort of surprised we're wasting so much time on this because...
Yeah, this is boring.
It is, because you've been caught in a lie. I mean, this happened 10 minutes ago, and you're still trying to wriggle out of it. It's actually
pretty
hilarious.
Basically, what you're saying is, you know, how do you think you got my name? And I told you that I watched Give Me a Break Man's
video. Almost a year later, you watched the video and you saw the name Edward. And then you retroactively left a comment calling me Edward on a video that was removed. Is that what happened?
His video is still sitting up there.
Crazy Caleb's?
Let me see. No, Give Me a Break Man's
video.
Yeah,
you're very confused.
No, you're confused. I don't see why you give a shit anyway. What's the big deal? Oh, you stupid advertisements. Hold on a second. There we go.
All I asked for was the link.
I'm putting it up. There it is.
You put a link in Blog TV?
Yeah. Oh, you're a damn advertisement. You got a big old block right in the middle of the screen, and got some shit going over on the left side of the screen. Okay, why does this bother you so much?
Just,
I mean, I guess I don't understand why you're aggravated. I watched the Give Me a Break Man video. He did a shout out. Your name was mentioned. Whoop de doo. So
what? Do
shout outs to me all the time.
What was the date of that video?
Oh,
read it out. Read it out for me.
And stuff. That was a long time ago. After he started doing videos promoting your
you just had it opened.
You had open.
You just had the video open.
I'm not looking at all that stuff. I'm just telling where I basically heard that. You got a shout out from your friend.
You mean the Japundit?
Shout outs on YouTube.
You mean the Japundit guy got a shout out?
He said Edward in the video and stuff.
Yeah,
and
he said the Japundit guy, the 60-year-old man. Is named Edward, and that was almost a year later. All right, let's move on, okay? Because I have some other interesting shit on this topic that you might want to see. Here we go.
I see some dude with glasses on the screen.
Yeah, that's Edward.
Oh.
Okay, so. I mean, that's the guy that your buddy edited out of the audio clip in the video he uploaded, because obviously you guys knew exactly what you were doing. I mean, there's nothing you can really say about it. So here is a video that you do not know about. Actually, nobody knows about this. I was in your stickam room soon after you left those comments. And I was asking you about it. I was pretending to be a subscriber of yours and of Straightd0pe. And I got you to give me a story. And it's very interesting, actually, what you said. People may want to full screen this so that they can read exactly.
You have never come into my stick.
No. Yeah, I know. I was under a different name, obviously.
Oh, you were being deceptive, is what you're saying.
I was engaging in a bit of espionage, is what I was doing.
Oh, boy, that's clever of you.
Yeah, I'm much more clever than you, that's for sure. Why don't we watch this, okay? I'm going to play it for everybody.
Anything that you're taking in right now through your optic nerve could be an illusion, technically. You could be a vegetable laying on a bed somewhere with a feeding tube, you know what I mean, and an oxygen mask on. You don't know for certain that you are even you. Everything we take is on faith. So, you know.
Okay, now I paused it for a second because this is sort of important. Now, I want everyone to see what you did here when I asked how you found the name Edward in connection with Straightd0pe. And what you did was you put up a link to Google search results. And I just want to draw everyone's attention to this little bit right here, which says Straightd0pe plus Edward, which is obviously not the way you would have come across it, because you would have already been looking for the name Edward. So you're basically being completely dishonest to everyone in that stickcam room. It was only like 6 or 7 people, so obviously you don't give a shit and people don't really care what's going on. But, so here you are misleading everyone, and I will, I'll continue playing the video, and we can say what you say after, we can see what you say after that.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
If you guys don't mind real quick, that society poet, can you do me a favor real quick? That society poet, so you can be a witness to this as well, Sister Sunshine. Can you copy that link and paste it in? It's basically a Google search of what comes up. Let me know what you see.
What I see is the first entry is a blog spot a thing called Steve Edwards or something, and it says the blog is called The Straightd0pe. That's pretty much the first one. Yeah, that's like the first thing I see. Yeah. That's what I see. I don't know if that's what you have with me to see about that. But.
Mm, Okay. So what's
that's
the deal?
Pretty much it. It's right there. Simple search in Google and bam.
Well, obviously, for one thing, you don't mention a thing about Gimme a Break Man for where you came up with the name Edward. Another thing is you're clearly being deceptive to everyone there, and you're leading them to a Google search that you shouldn't have come up with without the name Edward in your search query.
Where do you think that I would have even come up with that idea in the first place? I mean, this is silly. He gave you a shout-out. How do you think that I would have been able to know your first name if he had not give you a shout-out? What would have I done? Put my hands together and prayed to God and said, "Dear God, what's this man's name?"
Where is this shout-out? I mean, why are you back on this?
I gave you the link to the guy's deal.
Here,
I'm basically asking you, how do you think that I would have known your first name if your best friend would not have said that in the video?
You found a video where he said the name Edward in reference to someone completely different, again, almost a year later. And this was done before you started claiming that, which was just this week. And you say it was just a Google search. I actually have your conversation with Terrorizing and Damon Colon where you also say it was just a Google search. You make no mention of Gimme a Break Man. You say, "Oh, just a Google search of Straightd0pe, and there's Edward all over the place." And here, in Stickham, you were turning a last name somehow into Edward and Ed, and addressing me by that. That's your explanation. I mean, you're not being consistent. You're not being consistent because you're lying.
The guy did a shout-out video towards you, so what? Big deal.
Yeah, you know, okay, so what...
I've had people do shout-outs saying, "Hey, check out Brett Keane," you know?
Yeah, Brett, where's the shout-out video where he says the name Edward? I want to see the video where he mentions...
the link, man.
He mentions me in that video? He mentions me.
I will post this in Blog TV again.
Do it.
There it is. That's the, like, third, fourth time now.
It's not showing up for me for some reason.
Well, I'll post it in Skype for you as well.
Post it in Blog TV so everyone can see it.
There it is. It is in Blog TV, man. It's going up the screen. I'll even post it again for you.
No one in Blog TV seems to be able to see it. Oh. Are you in a waiting room?
I don't know. It just says, it looks the same to me. How am I supposed to know if I'm in a waiting room? Yes, I am in a waiting room. How about that? That's why. I guess that's why they're not seeing the link. I apologize. I didn't know that I was looking at the Skype picture. Fuck you, idiots. I don't do Blog TV. I don't give a shit about this. First time Straightd0pe's ever done a damn show, according to him. So how am I supposed to know? I didn't know you guys weren't getting the link. No, it's just annoying.
I haven't done many Skype calls, so okay.
We're sitting here arguing over a shout out video and your name being mentioned in the comments and
Brett. Again, yeah. September 25th, 2010. You left those comments December 2009. So how do you explain that? Just try to explain that. Be my guest.
That's a while back, dude. I don't know all that kind of stuff. All I know is I watched Gimme a Break a while back and did my thing.
Okay, so when Brett Keane Jr. posted his video with the audio.
Junior.
Yeah, it's insanely hilarious.
It is hilarious.
Why would he cut out the name Japundit, the Japundit guy? Why would that be necessary if you thought... he was referring to me.
He didn't make that video.
Who did?
So I sat there and wanted to show you basically where that came from. I seen a video that you done basically making all kinds of accusations.
So you cut out the Japundit guy from the audio. You did that.
I sat there and showed you that he mentioned you in the shout out.
You edited out who he was actually talking about.
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Okay.
The video,
all right,
Brett. Man's original video sits there and shows your name in the thing. you did a shout out, put a link of you in the description.
Yeah, again, almost a year later. All right. If that's how you want to play it, I guess you can see how many people believe your lying ass.
I don't give a shit if these people believe anything. They're here for a shit slinging contest anyway, and you know it.
Yeah, and you're losing hard already. I've barely gotten into it.
Hard at what? You're sitting here saying, oh, you made a comment to me. Oh, you said this. You also said that you tried to come into a room under a deceptive name and everything. I mean, so
yes,
what?
Yes, I did. And I'm showing that you're contradicting yourself. I'm also showing that you're being dishonest to everybody here by claiming that a video made almost a year later is where you got the name that you put in comments. So...
Okay, I don't see the relevancy. Can we move along? What else you got for me?
Do you have a time machine, Brett?
I wish.
I bet you do.
I'd travel back to the time of the dinosaurs and see what's going on.
I'm sure you'd take back a lot of things if you had a time machine, Brett.
Anything else for me? Are you there? Did you disconnect?
No, I'm here.
Okay.
Okay, so I guess we can move on. I think we all know what was really going on there. So maybe I'll just ask one more time. If you really believe that was my name, why do you think it would be okay to put that in a comment? I really want to hear an explanation.
What's wrong with sitting there just saying, hey, Ed, what's going on? I mean, who gives a shit?
Well, because I never attached a first name to my account, so why do you think it's appropriate for you to try to reveal one?
Do you feel like, is that what the deal is here? Is that the problem? You feel like somehow you were being exposed or revealed? Is that why you're bothered by this?
Well, I don't feel like anything. I know that that's what you were trying to do, and I want to hear your explanation for why that's ethically or morally okay to do.
Because he mentioned it in video, so I figured you didn't have
any
problem with that.
Oh my god. Okay. That's pathetic, but alright.
What's my name?
Your name is the name that you say in every single video you make.
Okay.
Brett D. Keane.
Actually, I usually just say Brett Keane and stuff. I don't say Brett D. Keane.
My mistake. Okay, I'll just move on to some other shit. Are you writing anything these days? You working on any new novels or anything?
No.
How come?
Because I basically suck as a writer. I wrote some stuff a long, long time ago, and basically down in notepads and stuff, and I had a couple of friends type up for me because I got terrible eyes.
Brett, how can you suck as a writer when you have such raving reviews?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. I mean, here's a link to Eternal Undying Love 3. You have rave reviews here from, a website that doesn't exist.
What would that be?
DetectiveLovers.org. Are these reviews real, Brett? I guess that's my question.
I did a video website a long time ago called GodHateYou.com, and I also had opened up something. This was years and years ago, back in the day, whenever I was doing like Yahoo chat, and I used to have people get on a thing called Shoutcast. You know what that is?
No, I don't.
Shoutcast is basically, do you know of a program called Winamp out there?
Yes, I do.
Okay, Winamp has this like production on it where if you wanted to, you could put this like widget type of deal on your site where people can get on and they can sit there and have a conversation with you. And I was trying to do some kind of internet radio. It was not successful whatsoever, but it was on my website, and I would sit there and talk to people and everything. And there were some people from the website who were members of that. That website got hacked. I got basically screwed over on that. It had a forum. Had all kinds of stuff. I used to record my voice doing like MP3s and all that. The website got hacked. But I had people over there. We had actually had like this thing where people could talk about mystery novels and stuff. And we also had a forum where people could debate religion and all that kind of stuff.
That sounds very exciting. What's the point?
It's not very exciting, though. Well, the point is I had people over there that were members and everything like that, people who were basically doing their own self-published books, magazines, and stuff like that. Not big-time Stephen King crap or anything, but just self-published where you... Have you ever used Lulu before? A lot of atheists on YouTube have used Lulu.
No, I have not written anything and put it on Lulu, and... What are you getting at, Brett? Are you saying that your website, what was that, godhatesyou.com, got hacked? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
What? And
also, my Serpent's Cradle Radio, which is actually named after the third book. If you look, it says the Serpent's Cradle. That was the name of the third book. These are old-ass things that I wrote whenever I was younger and then later on had typed out and stuff and had it printed out.
Yeah, they did read like they were written by a high school student, so I was wondering if they were actually written when they were published. So you didn't answer my question. Are these real editorial reviews or not?
They're reviews basically from some of the members and stuff who used to be on the site. It's not like professionals. The book itself wasn't professional. None of that was professional. It was all self-published.
I know they're self-published, Brett. So you're saying that users on these sites, individual users on detectivelovers.org and horror.com and pagans.com, wrote these things.
Yeah, on Amazon you can sit there and have it to where people can leave reviews and they can sit there and put stars if they like it, if they don't.
No, but I'm not talking about the Amazon user reviews. These are supposed to be editorial reviews from other websites.
This is in the
book info section. This is not the feedback section. This is not where people rate the book on Amazon. These are supposed to be editorial reviews from book reviewers.
Basically what happens is whenever you want to use the thing like Lulu and stuff, Lulu.com, you go over there, you upload either like a WordPress, a notepad, it could be like just pretty much whatever kind of thing you can do text on. People leave their reviews over on Lulu as well as sit there and leave their, you know, whatever. And then what happens is whenever Lulu decides to, and they want to cross-post it to something like Barnes & Nobles or some kind of book company, that stuff transfers over to it. I mean, it's very clear and stuff that this is people who are sitting there just dropping reviews and everything. It's not professionals.
Actually,
these aren't experts or anything like that. I don't even know professional review people.
So you're saying Amazon took this from Lulu? That's what you're saying?
The information basically transfers over from that and everything, and then there's people also from Amazon who use Amazon Store.
That's not these people. That's not detectivelovers.org. That's not horror.com or pagans.com.
They're just members and stuff like that who did their own thing. It's not professionals. That's what I'm getting at.
So who wrote in pagans.com?
Who put reviews that basically probably either transferred over on Lulu or... However,
so you don't know.
These are
basically
not professionals. This is like no big deal. You know, it's just people who write their damn reviews and say what they think.
Well, strange that the websites are being misrepresented. Then, I guess you don't know anything about that, or so.
I had a lot of websites connected through me and stuff. I had a lot of like on my. If you look at my BrettKeane.com website right now, you will see that I have a friends page. I have pages that basically go off to all kinds of different directions and stuff like that, and whatever has to do with me on it. So that's how I got it on BrettKeane.com.
I don't know how that's connected.
Don't you have a website of your own?
No, I don't, Brett.
Haven't you ever had like a friends section or something where you're trying to basically promote people's websites, or you just put people's link of things that you think are interesting?
So you're saying that these came from your website on Lulu? Or your personal website?
This stuff just transferred over from Lulu. People leave reviews. They tell you if they think your book sucks, blows, goat balls, or if they like it or not. That's just it. You know?
Okay, well, then you may feel like contacting Amazon and letting them know that these actually qualify as false endorsements because you're misrepresenting the source, or someone's misrepresenting the source. And that's actually...
That's actually
against the U.S. code.
That's to contact Amazon for your books years ago and tell them that, you know, I don't like some of the reviews. Is that what you're saying?
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that what's happening here is against the United States code because these websites are being misrepresented. These reviews are being misattributed to websites.
Restroom. Hold on 1 second. I'll be as quickly as possible. I promise. Be right back.
Try not to pinch a loaf or anything.
I'm trying not to, man.
Is everybody enjoying themselves so far?
Sorry about that, man. Shit, we've been sitting here for a while. Okay, so what else you got for me? You don't like reviews? Okay, cool. Next, what do you got?
Well, I haven't gotten to the most interesting one yet, which is the one from your website.
Oh, you always got to save the best for last, right? Let's see what you got.
This book is a hellish roller coaster that I had the pleasure of writing from Serpent's Cradle Magazine at your personal website.
Yeah, we were trying to basically get a magazine thing together that was named after the third book.
Did you ever publish one?
What?
Did you ever publish a Serpent's Cradle magazine?
It was like a self-published thing and stuff, but...
So you did publish at least one issue?
We tried to do all this kind of stuff, but the person that I had that was supposed to do all the artwork and everything, it didn't go through, and I did sit there and, you know, try, but the guy, he was a really... originally supposed to do the illustrations and shit. That'd sit there. I think he ended up leaving. Let me see what the fuck. Man, this is years ago, dude. I can't believe it.
I know it's hard to keep track of your scams, Brett. Just try really hard.
Shit. Come on, man. Relax, dude. It's a long time.
I know it's a weekly occurrence at least, so I mean, I'd have trouble keeping track of myself.
Yeah, I'm going to probably rob a bank next week, too. Sure. Come on, man.
You know, if your agoraphobia doesn't stop you.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's funny, right? I know. It's a laugh riot.
Harsh. Let's see.
Was that below the belt?
See, is that one below the belt? No, I think you could do better than that. Come on, man. That was a long time ago. I'm not completely sure of every single detail on that shit.
You don't know every detail on the publication of your own personal magazine some 4 years ago or so.
It didn't work out, man. It was basically just some kind of deal. I wanted to get it together, have the members of the website participate in it, but we couldn't get any like people who would be able to do like good artwork. I mean, I can somewhat draw, but it ain't all that great.
So what you're saying is the magazine never existed?
It existed for a little bit until
you said you tried and you couldn't do it. You couldn't do it.
Get any illustrations for it and stuff.
Okay, so there was no
over Lulu, and basically told people, look, you know, we're trying to get this done and everything like that. And some of the members actually reviewed the book and stuff on there. So that's. That's all we have.
Okay, do you remember who wrote that particular line? One of your potential magazine contributors wrote this. I assume you're that's what you're getting at. So do you remember who wrote this?
Oh, let me see. What do you got a link in Skype? Dude, it's been a long time since I looked over there. That shit doesn't even go anywhere, like I told you and stuff. It was a long time ago. The shit just didn't work through. What do you got?
What doesn't go anywhere? What do you mean?
The books. They were written whenever I was younger and shit and had some people type it out.
People
don't even bother with it.
But people can still buy them and you still get paid for them.
They could, but yes. It doesn't sell.
So they're sitting there with these... reviews there, these misattributed reviews, and one from your personal website and a magazine that you tried to start but couldn't get off the ground.
I was trying to start with some other people, kind of a collaboration.
Right. Thing. So who wrote that review?
Which review are you talking about? There's a lot of reviews on Amazon.
The one from Serpent's Cradle magazine.
Oh, let me see.
It says, "The book is a hellish roller coaster that I had the pleasure of writing." A hellish roller coaster, Brett.
Oh. Oh, man. Yeah, that was back whenever I was religious. Well, damn, that was a long time ago, man.
How was that back when you were religious?
Let me take a look. Because I wrote it whenever I was younger, and then it was all sitting in notepads, basically just sitting there going nowhere and everything like that. And, you know, some buddies of mine, they basically looked at it and they said, "Dude, I think you should put it out," and all that. I didn't think it was any good.
Brett, I'm not talking about the book. I'm talking about the website.
Which website are you talking about?
Serpentscradle.com was not launched while you were still religious. I'm talking about that review, Brett. I'm not talking about when you wrote the book.
The books were written back
then. I'm not talking about when you wrote the book. I'm talking about the book review from Serpent's Cradle magazine at serpentscradle.com. That's all I'm talking about. I don't care when you wrote the books. I don't care if you wrote them in Word or Notepad or if you scrawled them on fucking toilet paper. I'm wondering about this one review.
You're talking about Amazon. Which link are you talking about, though? There's three books up there, man. Can you give me an idea which one you're going for? I haven't looked at this shit for a very long time.
It's Eternal and Dying Love 3. Okay. Serpents in the Cradle.
All right. Eternal and Dying. Oh, goodness. That's such a long time.
Yeah, I know. Just do your best, Brett.
I'm doing the best I can. Get this old man a chance. Come on, sir.
You're only 34, I thought.
Yeah, that's right.
34 is old now?
Age now?
I thought 30, the 30s were the new 20s.
You don't believe my age either?
I don't hear too many 34-year-olds referring to themselves as old men, that's all. I'm just saying. So back to the review, please.
Okay, let's see what we got. How old do you think I am there?
I didn't say I don't believe you. Sure, if you're 34, you're 34.
Anything else I say, if I tell you I gotta sit there and, you know, go to the bathroom, you might not even believe
trust
where
me,
you are.
I don't believe you because of your exemplary record.
All right, let's see. Okay, there's a shitload of reviews here, man. Which one are you talking about?
There are four editorial reviews right under the graphic. Four of them. It's pretty prominent right there. Editorial reviews. The last one is from Serpent's Cradle magazine.
All right, let me look.
Let's see. I thought you were looking already.
I am looking and stuff. Dude, I got shitty eyes, man. I'm as blind as a fucking bat.
I thought you got your glasses.
It's still bad eyes, man.
That sucks.
Yeah. Let's see. Alright, let's see. Okay, I see. Alright, serpentscradle.com. I guess this is obviously somebody that sat there and left something a while back. It's probably either a guy that I knew back then and stuff named Steve or Mike and stuff. So I used to sit there and go into Yahoo a long time ago, and, you know, people would sit here and, you know, I'd say, okay, this is my book, yada yada yada. People left reviews. You know, I started I put my PDF files out online and stuff and just started basically letting people read the crap for free a while back because I didn't think, you know, why bother sitting there doing it like this? They weren't selling anyway. You there?
Yeah, I'm here. I was just waiting for you to actually give me a legitimate explanation. I mean, you're talking about Yahoo.com and people leaving messages here and there. I mean, these are supposed to be editorial reviews. This says Serpent's Cradle Magazine. Are you saying some random person left this on Yahoo and now it's on Amazon? And it's attributed to your personal website, which is no longer.
What Lulu does is you sit there, people type things and stuff like that, and then what happens is it came over to this. It's like whenever you get like an ISBN and stuff like that, it just transfers over.
So who wrote this?
It could have either been Mike or it could have been Steve in this situation. I'm not sure.
On behalf of Serpent's Cradle Magazine.
This actually might have, because it's so long ago, I might have sat here and put something on the comments section to somebody and it went over. It would be like you leaving a comment on YouTube and then if you opened up like a Vlogger thing or something, the information, the comments, all of it transfers over kind of like a
Did you feed. Just say that you may have written this?
May have. It was a long time ago.
And it got transferred
from Lulu.
Right. It got transferred over to Lulu, attributed to a magazine that was never finished, and your personal website. And I guess this was just some through the processes of Lulu or Amazon.
The reason why I think that it might have been something from a comment that I made that transferred over is because of the way it's worded. It says that I had the pleasure that couldn't have been because it says writing, R-I-D-I-N-G.
Yeah, try another one.
Alright,
I see. Yeah, you may have written it,
claiming comments board over on Lulu, and it transfers all that stuff over.
Would you maybe have signed that comment, Serpent's Cradle Magazine?
I'm trying to tell you and try to help you understand this. So on the comments section of my Lulu, is when you write the shit, it transfers over. That's how they did it.
And it gets put into editorial reviews, even though it could be any Joe Schmo anywhere.
Dude, under the name, you know. It says Serpent's Cradle, you know. Dude, Serpent's Cradle is the name of my book. So what?
So some guy named Dude69 writes some shit on Lulu.com as a comment. It's going to get transferred to Amazon under editorial reviews.
Dude, I don't work for Lulu.com, okay, man. So it's a company that self-publishes. I have no idea how they sit there and they do all this transfer shit. I don't work in that kind of business, so I don't know.
So you don't know why Lulu would have written Serpent's Cradle Magazine and serpentscradle.com.
People left comments on Lulu all the time, and then it transferred over whenever they started posting it all over the place.
So people left comments.
I don't know why it showed up like this.
So people left comments and used a username that was your personal website or signed it as your personal website and a magazine that you say you were actually trying to start but never did. You're saying this was someone else, but it might have been you, but maybe not. It might have been a comment. Might have been from Yahoo. I mean,
you know how many comments all over websites and all over people's YouTube videos I've done? How am I supposed to remember every single damn comment and thing that is said over this? Can you remember what you like wrote 5 years ago on, you know, Joe Blow video or something like that? I can't. I'm sorry that doesn't work for you, but shit, I can't remember everything.
Yeah, if I wrote a book review for my own book and tried to play it off as some kind of magazine, I would probably remember that.
My books,
I have a decent memory, though, so.
They're for the public to be able to read free. It's no shit. It's no big deal, man.
Read
so
free.
What?
Okay, so what now? Okay. All right, that'll do. Move on to something else. Since we're on the topic of writing and everything, why don't we talk about you plagiarizing Judy Burnett's poem?
I never plagiarized anybody's stuff.
Well, hundreds of people witnessed you publishing a video with her poem in it, and you had by Brett Keane in the description. So how do you explain that?
Well, that's a lie.
It's a lie?
I never plagiarized anybody's stuff. There was a woman a while back that sat there and claimed that I did that. And that woman later on ended up calling people a bunch of pedophiles on YouTube, and she no longer exists over there.
No, Brett, I don't care what she did later. That has nothing to do with the video that she put out. There was a screen cap, and it showed your video, and it said, by Brett Keane in the description. And you removed the video soon after. It's a lie?
I just told you that I did not do this, so...
You're saying it did not say by Brett Keane in the description?
No. It said video by Brett Keane, but the poem actually said who it was by.
What did it say specifically?
It said the woman's name.
It just said the woman's name? What do you mean?
It says poem by this and video by Brett Keane. That's
so it says poem by Judy Burnett. That's what it said in your description, you're saying? Okay, well, that's still plagiarism, sorry to say, because...
That's not plagiarism to sit there and do a poem review or a movie review, Brett.
No, it wasn't a review. You changed the title. You edited the text. You took out words in almost every stanza. You added words, and you removed the last stanza of the poem, probably because it mentions Jesus. And yeah, I'm sorry to say, but misquoting somebody... Brett, misquoting somebody still counts as plagiarism. If you attribute something to a person and you change it for your own purposes, that's plagiarism. So either what a whole bunch of people witnessed
happened, or what you say happened,
either way it's plagiarism. Either way you want to slice it. So what do you have to say about that?
And I'm sitting here telling you, so you're basically trying to say that if someone does a video where they review a poem or a movie that they watched or something like that and sat there and said how they feel about it or anything, that's like, oh boy.
Oh, it was a review. Really? It was a review. You reviewed the poem.
Poems and movies I like all the time, so what? Oh,
right. So you changed the title. You didn't comment on the poem. You changed the words of the poem, and that's a review.
What are you talking about? Change the title.
The title of your video was Erase My Innocence.
Poem review, I don't know what you're talking about on this other stuff. What is this, Erase My Innocence?
Yeah, that was the title of your poem, and you even added...
That's bullshit right there.
Do you want me to...
I don't know where you got that idea from.
Do you want me to...
It was poem review, basically. Talk about how the poem identified with something that happened in my life. I was talking about how she went through something. Judy's father in the poem had a heart attack, dude.
This is true. Listen. I'm listening.
My mother passed away. The poem meant a lot to me. So I shared that I feel a lot like what this lady's saying in a poem.
So you're saying that your video was actually you commenting on a poem?
Yeah, I was commenting, basically sitting there saying how I feel about the deal.
Oh, do you want me to play the video?
Sure.
Okay, and we'll see that, though the poem was called Dad, and it says Dad all throughout the poem, it doesn't appear once in your video. You do not comment on the video at all. You do not say a word.
You said that it was called Erase My Innocence.
No, your video was called Erase My Innocence. The poem was called Dad, which you took out of the poem. Here, I'll play the clip for everybody. We can watch your whole original video, and we'll see if there's any reviewing or commentary going on. How about that? Is that what you want? All right.
Play a full video.
I'll do it. Just watch the video, Brett. Where do you start reviewing the poem that you changed? I'm just curious.
At the end, fast forward it so we can get to talk. Why is the video looped like that?
This was your editing job, motherfucker.
Oh. you fucking must have edited it because it keeps on looping over and over and over again.
Nothing's looping.
Just look at the way my fucking head keeps going back and forth and shit on the damn video.
That's just what you look like, Brett. I'm sorry.
Shit, dude. You fucking edit this damn video, man. That's fucking... Dude, listen, I don't mind sitting here answering your question.
Just watch the video, please.
Yeah, great food.
That's the whole video, Brett. Where was the commentary? Where was the review? Brett, you there?
Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
That's okay.
It was fucking muted. Yeah, the thing is, it's obvious that this fucking video was edited. You
how
can
so?
See that shit was fucked with.
How so?
Because the way my fucking head keeps on, like, swaying back to the left like that over and over.
Brett, how could that...
In the video, I sit there and leave a goddamn bunch of comments and shit about it.
You
fucking cut it up or something?
No, Brett. That's how your video went up, and it could not have been edited to change what your head's doing while the text is staying constant like that. I couldn't have taken your original video and fucked with it and just changed what your head does.
I came here to answer questions and do your show and shit, but if you're gonna sit there and like edit my clips and shit, that's fucking wrong, man.
Did you do this
or did you have somebody else? Did you get this from some other troll or whatever? I presume
you have the original video then, and you can produce it because this is all about presenting evidence, right? This is all about presenting evidence, right? You say no one has evidence for their claims,
and you know that.
You didn't back up your videos.
I was flagged off of fucking YouTube, man.
You didn't. Well, you doc dropped and got booted off of YouTube. But,
no bullshit, man.
Okay, but. You're saying that you didn't have your videos backed up.
I lost hundreds of goddamn videos. There was only some that I had left after that. It's heartbreaking, dude, to sit there and lose that many damn videos.
I'm sure it is. So you're saying that this...
Yeah, I know you don't care, but you guys have fucking, like, cut up my videos. You try to make me out to look like an asshole, and that's ignorant,
man. So you're saying this was doctored?
Yeah. It's obvious. Anybody who's sitting there watching it, you can see the way my head just keeps on looping back and forth and shit.
Who did it?
How am I supposed to know, man?
Well, this is how it appears in Judalicious's video, which came out, the same day that you posted yours? So you're saying... And then this is a completely separate video. So how did this happen?
If you look through my Mr. Evolution right now that's fucking suspended and everything for 2 weeks, the videos are still up. You will see that in the past, I've been known for doing my game reviews. I've done videos where I fucking talk about, like I did a video where I talked about the difference between horror film characters and all that. I used to do videos like that all the time where I would review fucking, you know, talk about a book I read, something about George Carlin or, you know, just anything.
You read books?
Sometimes. It's fucking hard to do nowadays because of my eyesight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're just falling apart. So let me get this straight. Your story is that this whole thing was faked. It's completely doctored. And the original video, original video was just you reviewing this poem, even though the poem was changed.
In every one of my damn videos that I do reviews and I'm sitting there talking and shit like that, I will usually show like footage of a video game like that. Like back in the day and stuff, whenever I was doing like free demos that are online, I'd show people the stuff and then I would talk about it. But later on, as I got better at video making and everything, I got to the point where I could sit there and talk during some of the footage that was going on without it fucking up. So,
How come you never claimed that Judalicious edited your video? all you ever claimed was that you, in the description, you credited the original author. You never claimed that she doctored your video or edited it in any way. So how come now the whole thing was just faked? Why is that your story now?
So it's obvious that somebody doctored this fucking thing that you put up.
Why is it so obvious?
Because of the way it's moving and shit. And plus, your video ends without me talking and shit and saying, look, you know, my mother passed away. This poem meant a lot to me and stuff, written by this lady because her father died. You could tell by whenever you're, like, reading the, you know, the stuff up there that it's about a woman who lost her father. I mean, it's clear, dude.
You can tell that.
Why would anybody sit there and think any other thing, because it's talking about a woman who lost her father.
How are we supposed to be able to tell that when the word dad isn't in there once?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you removed the word dad, so how are we supposed to know this is a poem about where a woman talks about her father?
Is an edited fucking video. You make fancy ass videos all the time where you got my head floating around doing all kinds of stupid shit. Anybody can, hell, if somebody wanted to, they can make it look like you're having sex with a dolphin on YouTube. That's how fucking great technology's gotten. How about that?
Okay, so you're saying Judalicious did this in 2006.
Judalicious accused me of this. She accused me of that. And
she edited. She edited your video. That's what you're saying.
She later on accused people of pedophilia and all that kind of stuff.
No, I don't care. I don't care about. Okay, for one thing, that was a joke later on, and it was stupid. But I don't care about that. That has nothing to do with this.
You never
accused her of editing your video and making it look like you were doing something you weren't. You said that it was a false accusation of plagiarism because you credited...
This is an edited video, man. This is obviously somebody fucking screwed with the damn video and did what they want with it.
Can I play another clip for you, please?
I guess. Go ahead.
Oh, thank you very much.
I ended up making a video because I was still reeling over the pain of losing my mother, where I actually used a poem that was done by a person called Judy Burnett. In the poem, it talks about Judy Burnett, how she felt about her father, who passed away from, I believe, a heart attack. And after reading the poem, I felt like it was talking to me. I felt like the poem represented my emotions and my feelings about the loss of my mother. So I decided to do a video where I showed the poem up in the video and talked about basically how it is that I felt about the loss of my mother and how I identified with the poem. I gave full credentials and credits to the person who made the poem, but Judalicious got this bright ass idea.
Oh, can you pause it real quick? Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, you claimed about 6 months ago or so that, yeah, you talked about it afterwards, but you did say that you made a video showing the poem and sitting there.
That video that you just played just sat there and signified that right there. I have said over and over that I talked in the video.
Okay, so it was a...
showed it.
So let's pretend that you did, okay? You reviewed a poem after changing the words.
I did not change any of the words on there. It was written by this woman. It went just as it went. This video that you're showing right here is a doctored video.
So the text, you didn't do the text. Judalicious did all that? Is that what you're saying?
The video originally had some text, but it's obviously...
Was this the text?
Kind of loop spin with the...
Was this the text of your video?
Dude, I'm telling you, I looked at your video that you just played, and the goddamn thing is doctored. Somebody fucked with it.
But you can't produce the original to show us that.
My account was removed.
I realize that.
I lost a lot of videos, man. Tons of videos. I even lost some great fucking church phone calls, too.
So are you saying that, Judalicious's screen cap was also doctored?
Let me see, that was a while back. How long was it? Yeah, it's been a long time. It was like the fucking old account on there. She started all kinds of shit. Yeah. She started a lot of shit.
Yes or no?
I may have said that she fucking did it because she probably... Let me see, it was a long time ago. She probably fucking doctored a screenshot on it.
Okay, Brett. You may have said it, so maybe it happened. Okay.
Because this shit is fucking nonsense. It's a lie. She also accused people of pedophilia as well.
Look, that's completely irrelevant. Her video came out very soon after yours. So I would like you to tell me. I would like you to tell me what was edited out of it. What was changed by Judalicious, apparently?
It was years ago, dope.
Did she change the text of the clip of your video that she used?
This is old news, dope. The video that you played up or anything is doctored. It's clear that even the recording that you just played said that I talked at the end of the video, so...
Well, that's you giving the same story. That doesn't mean it happened.
Well, I don't know what to tell you about that. This shit's old, and it's fucking over in my mind.
Well, we're talking about the false accusations made against you, right? So this is... doesn't matter how long ago it happened. This is something that people remember.
Dude, you have shown in your videos that you're able to edit. I've seen some of Coughlin's friends' videos where he makes Thunderfoot look like a fucking Muslim with a turbine. You know, who gives a shit? You guys do this kind of crap to people all the time. You make fucking videos making a guy look like he's in a crowd of Muslims holding up signs and shit. What do you do?
Who do you think edited the video? Just curious. Do you think it was me, or do you think it was Judalicious?
Oh, fuck. This particular video, I don't know what the hell I'm looking at here. I don't know who did what. I don't know you guys personally.
And?
And what?
So what? You don't know us personally. What does that have to do with anything?
How am I supposed to know who does what with you guys? That thing with Jubilicious was a long-ass time ago.
Well, Brett, when you were talking about her making that video, accusing you of plagiarism, how come you didn't mention then that she edited the whole thing and made it look like you changed the poem? Why didn't you say that then?
The shit that went down a long time ago, that was an old ass account. A lot of things in my life are completely different now. A lot of things have went through. That's like some YouTube drama a long fucking time ago. Can't remember every single damn thing, every single comment and shit. Can't even remember every single video that I've talked in.
That doesn't...
You want to say, what was your favorite five videos 3 years ago? How the fuck am I supposed to know? Would you be able to remember that?
It doesn't answer my question.
Well, I don't know what the fuck the deal is back then. I just know that video you just played is fucking doctored. It doesn't have me talking in it. It doesn't have any sound.
But you never accused Judalicious of altering the text in your video, did you?
Dude, I've seen a lot of videos where people got me doing all kinds of silly ass shit and stuff.
Yeah, no, just answer my question. I don't want you to go on another tangent.
I don't know everything about this. This is not something that I fucking think about every single day. It's bullshit.
Right, so now you're claiming that the video was doctored, even though you never said that before.
The video that you played right here is fucking doctored. You can clearly see the way my head's swaying back and forth and shit. It's obviously somebody cut it up.
So are you saying Judalicious did this?
I don't know who fucking did this video.
Wait, why am I talking to two people now?
This is my wife sitting in.
I know who it is.
I don't know who fucking did this to this video.
Do you need your wife's, Brett, do you need your wife's help?
No, I'm actually...
No, I'm asking Brett.
I'm smoking a cigarette.
Okay.
I'm gonna go to bed.
It's clear for anybody that sees this video that the head's swaying back and forth, all these weird random ass cuts.
If he got that video off of Judalicious's thing, then yeah, that's who doctored the video.
Judalicious, then that would be the deal.
No, see, because this is not Judalicious's video. This is the original. This is your video, Brett. You did those effects on your head because you wanted it to look all dramatic because people were criticizing you at the time and you wanted to bring up your dead mother. That's what happened. And these are your video effects with your head bobbing around.
In his original video, he said...
Forget the guy is fucking around. He's just putting edited video footage up there. Look, Dope, you want to ask me questions, fine, but don't be sitting here doing that kind of shit. We know that you're great at editing and all that. You want to try to make me look like a fucking idiot, so be it.
So you're accusing me of editing it. That's what you're doing.
I don't know, man. You're the guy who's playing the video, aren't you? How am I supposed to know? You make videos trying to make people look like dumbasses in your videos. How the fuck am I supposed to know?
Well, you want to look at Judalicious's video? So it'll be clear that if anyone did it, it's her, and you never accused her of doing that. All you said was that you actually credited the author.
I don't remember every single event that went down. I just know I had problems with a person a while back. This is not something I keep in mind on every single thing. Why would I sit there and give a shit and stuff? So what? It's another YouTube drama down the fucking tube. Who gives a shit?
You've retold this story like 10 times in separate videos. So obviously it is on your mind from time to time.
You're asking me a question. I'm telling you that I'm fucking... I don't know all the complete events of everything. It's been years. So what?
Okay. Why don't I play a bit of Judalicious's video?
What's all that shit at the beginning of the deal there?
That's Judalicious's commentary before she starts the video. And that was, she actually showed a screen cap of your video on a YouTube page.
Let me see. Rewind that real quick. Let me take a look at what this looks like.
How far do you want me to go?
I don't know. Let me see what the screenshot is that you think you got here.
Sure.
Just get to the screenshot, man. Come on, I want to see all this other shit.
There it is.
Let me see. Bullshit.
Bullshit.
That's right there. Yeah, because the description clearly sat there and said that it was the woman's poem and everything, and it said video produced by Brett Keane, not by Brett Keane. And that shit up there, that's nonsense as well. It was supposed to be a poem review.
Oh, really? So she doctored the whole thing, that's what you're saying.
Well, this fucking deal is. I don't know what the hell's going on here. This is bullshit.
It's funny, because you never accused her of that.
Movies, poems, I was doing fucking reviews on video games and stuff.
Yes.
You know, are you going to accuse me of fucking claiming to have created Warcraft now because of my game review? Come on, man, this is silly.
You're being silly. I mean,
yeah,
why would I accuse you of creating Warcraft? I mean, this wasn't...
Yeah, I'm sitting here trying to say that I'm doing whatever with this. This is dumb.
You said yourself that you sat there and played the poem in your video, right? Or showed the poem in your video.
This particular video that you played is the one that you played before is clearly fucking edited and doctored. This particular thing, like right here, I don't know what the fuck all this is about. But I can see right there in the text that is not the way it was said.
So this is her video. So you're saying that she did those effects for some reason.
What's the red letters there and all this shit? What is this?
Well, that's the actual text of the poem, not what you changed it to. You know exactly what it is. Give me a break, Brett. You've seen this before.
This is nonsense.
The innocence was not in the poem.
Why would I?
Did you write that?
That would be stupid to sit there and do. It would be like putting from what you're claiming, it'd be like putting like Enter the Sandman lyrics from Metallica in there and shit. Everybody would sit there and know. You're not going to get away with that kind of nonsense.
I'm not saying it wasn't stupid. It was very stupid.
Well, this is nonsense. These are edited fucking videos.
Okay. So you're saying Judalicious immediately doctored your video, and you're saying that she changed the text.
If you're saying that's her video and shit and her screenshot, then yeah, that would be bullshit, man. I would not sit there and claim that. I would not sit there and claim when I'm doing a review of a movie or any of that stuff that was mine, that it was by me. Nobody would fucking sit there and go for that. How could I say, oh yeah, Warcraft is by me? That would be stupid. It's a review, so what?
So you did not play the poem, show the poem with altered
talked in the video.
You showed the poem, right? The
recording that you showed. I talked in the recording, and I also put in the description it was made by the woman, and that's it. I already pointed this out like 5 fucking times.
Okay, and you showed the poem on screen, right?
This guy's sitting here, Doc. You must be doctoring the fucking videos and shit.
Just answer my question.
Dude, I've already given you plenty of time to sit here and do this, and you're editing videos and trying to fucking
make
me
look
shit.
Really?
Yeah, it
is. Are you looking for a way out?
Look, man, I came in here to sit here and answer your questions, play your little game, and have fun with you, but you have clearly edited this fucking material, or one of your buddies did it. I don't give a fuck. You guys do ignorant shit to Thunderfoot, Pat Kendall. You guys make him out to look like he's some fucking Muslim.
Who's us guys? Why are you grouping me in with anybody? I'm here.
I'm looking at the list.
I'm not in a club. I'm not on a team.
Samples. I've seen some of these videos. I've seen Coughlin's video that he mirrored up and shit where he's making Thunderfoot out to look like some Muslim.
Why do I care about Coughlin's videos? I'm not here. I'm not Coughlin.
Are these guys or not? Do you know
with them? I know them, sure.
What did you mod them for? Why did you mod these particular users for?
I'm on a friendly basis with these users. That doesn't mean what they do has anything to do with me.
I figured you guys are basically scumbags who will lie.
Us guys,
try to do whatever you can and shit to fuck with people.
You know what it sounds like to me? It sounds like you're squirming a little bit and you're like pulling out, you're going to your old bag of tricks.
Art video who edits videos to try to sit there and aggravate shit out of people.
Okay.
No one fucking cares except for a bunch of juveniles in a room, dope. You fucking either edited it or you had one of your buddies do it. What's next? What are you going to do now? You think you're going to pawn me, ask me some more stupid questions about something you think happened years ago or whatever?
Well,
I don't care.
Brett, either Judalicious, either...
my time with you, dope. No more attention for you, kid.
Oh, you're leaving. Oh, that's too bad. I didn't even get into the good stuff. I guess we knew it was going to happen eventually. Well, that's kind of disappointing. Brett didn't let me get to some of the main things I wanted to talk about. So what's the general consensus? What do you guys think about all that? He's a slippery fuck, I gotta say. He's very practiced at lying his ass off, being non-committal. I did my best to pin him down, but, you know, what can you do? Changed the story like 3 or 4 times on everything we were talking about. So anyway, I hope you guys got a fun show out of that at least. I'm thinking I may just make a video presenting the evidence that he didn't let me get to. I mean, there's still some juicy shit to talk about. So maybe you guys can look forward to that. And, you know, if Brett had just let me talk about everything I wanted to talk about, he wouldn't have to deal with that. But, because it's his fault. What are you going to do? I believe Happy Cabby is going to be doing some kind of after party live show on his YouTube channel. So if anyone wants to head over there, I'll probably go there and chat a bit about what happened. I hope a lot of you recorded that, because I didn't. And I'm sure regardless of what's shown, Brett will say that he was victorious, but it's to be expected. Anyway, thanks for showing up, everyone. Got a lot more people in here than I expected. And have a good night.